I realized all of my videos so far have focused on healthy food for adults. I've been neglecting a whole demographic. Sorry, buddy. So today we cover the science of breastfeeding. See, I got your back. Okay, we're gonna talk about the incredible biology of breastfeeding, but real quick, before we get started, in our society, there's a lot of pressure on mothers. There's a lot of pressure on women in general, but mothers even more. Pressure to be perfect, to do everything right, everything at the right time, to go by this imaginary checklist. I'm seeing that in my own family with all of my sisters going through motherhood and having to juggle the high expectations with the reality and just doing the very best they can. So as we go through all the information, we're going to keep in mind that the mother's circumstances are a huge factor. At the end of the day, it's much more about that connection between the mother and the baby than it is about being 100% perfect 100% of the time. And speaking of connection, that amazing bond between the mother and the baby, we've all seen it. That's not an accident. Breastfeeding causes the mother's brain to release hormones. Oxytocin is this really small hormone with amazing effects. It causes tiny contractions inside the breast that help push out the milk. Bottoms up, little dude. Even more amazing, oxytocin also works directly in the brain, both the mother's and the baby's, and it causes that feeling of bonding as well. Pretty useful hormone. And it's not just in humans. Check out this dog's behavior. The owner is on the right. The dog's facing the owner. The dog's facing the stranger. Now watch the dog after receiving some oxytocin. Laser focus. Completely ignores the stranger. So that's a pretty striking visual, and it's an example of how powerful this hormone can be. Now, that bond between the mother and the baby, not so surprising anymore, is it? Now, full disclosure, I'm not a mother. I really wanted to have some motherly input in this video, so I tried to shoot the whole thing with my sister and her 9-month-old. We had the whole thing set up. She had some great advice for soon-to-be mothers, but there was a tiny factor we couldn't control.
But I just kept going. And with
the recommendations, actually, there's a... medical organizations that recommend. Okay, another thing I wanted to ask you.
Okay.
I mean, you've heard that from us over the years.
Yes, right? I've heard about it.
So we're gonna try this again soon when he's in the mood, and we'll feed him right before, and we'll make sure all his needs are met, and we'll talk to his agent or whatever it takes. And we'll have a video coming up very soon with both of them. One thing we were chatting about a lot is he just loves eating his vegetables. It's just not a problem. Now, there are these fascinating studies showing babies tend to prefer the same foods the mother eats. It turns out the nutrients and the flavors in the food the mother's eating end up in the milk, and they influence the baby's preferences for solid food as well. This is so powerful, it works even before birth. The mom eats, the nutrients end up in the amniotic fluid, the baby is dipped in it, and after birth, he or she tends to prefer those same foods the mother was eating during pregnancy. Those are pretty incredible results. So if you want your kid to eat his veggies, you have to eat them yourself. Isn't it crazy that setting the example starts before the kid is even born? Another common question is, how long should we breastfeed for? What's the science on it? The World Health Organization, for example, recommends breastfeeding all the way to 2 years old if possible. Why? Well, one reason breastfeeding is so healthy are these molecules called oligosaccharides. They're basically natural sugars. Human milk oligosaccharides, or HMOs. And here's the amazing part. The baby can't even digest them. Can't break them down at all. Doesn't have the digestive enzymes. Turns out they're actually food for the microbes inside the baby. The microbiome, the collection of bacteria and other microorganisms inside the baby's gut. The microbiome is forming at this young age, and these oligosaccharides, these natural sugars, help feed and strengthen the good bacteria in the microbiome and prepare it for later on. Let's pause and think about that for a second. Evolution makes you produce these hundreds of natural sugars, these oligosaccharides, that the baby can't digest at all, because they feed little bacteria inside the baby's gut that are going to make the baby healthier later in life. Come on, science is amazing. These sugars, the oligosaccharides, they also help prevent infection by fighting the bad bacteria inside the baby's gut. So they promote growth of the good bacteria and they fight the bad bacteria. Two for the price of one. So those are some of the benefits of breastfeeding. Now, they have to be weighed against the circumstances. What makes sense in each person's case? My sister's thinking about whether she wants to go to 2 years old or she wants to stop earlier. She's still deciding. Breastfeeding is very taxing on her, and there's a lot of other circumstances as well. So it's up in the air, TBD. Some women can breastfeed more, longer, others shorter, and others not at all. That's okay. You do what you can, and don't put excessive pressure on yourself. One last thing. I know that in a lot of countries, there's this taboo around breastfeeding in public. I'm actually in Europe right now where people just don't care. But in the US, for some people, it's a big deal. Now, I'd hate to see somebody breastfeed less or miss an opportunity to do it because of social pressures or taboos. So, you know what? Just do it whenever you're ready for it, whenever it's convenient for you, and whenever the baby's ready. And somebody's got a problem with that, just tell them it's doctor's orders. Now, before you go, I know you got things to do, places to be, but if you found this video helpful or interesting at all, consider sharing it with other people who might benefit, and hit that like button and subscribe for future videos. Also, I just started this Facebook page where all the videos and other nutrition information will be posted on a regular basis, so check that out. I'll put a link in the description below. And feel free to link up with me on Twitter, where I share a lot of science information every day. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you on the next one. Bye-bye.